Hey, in this video I want to show you this insane music video transition. First of all, you need a person which will appear in your transition. In my case, that's 6-9. So now look for a point where the music video transition should happen. In my case, it's between these two frames here. So cut your video at the first frame where you can see your person. Now left click once your second part. And now press Alt and left click at the same time and duplicate your clip. Now right click your new clip and go to change clip speed and click freeze frame and click change. And yes, as you can see, your clip is now freezed at this frame. Now go to the beginning of your upper clip and go 13 frames to the right. Now cut again your upper clip and delete the right part. And now drag and drop your upper clip to the left so that the end of the upper clip fits into the end of your first clip. Now you have to select your upper clip and go into Fusion. Now drag and drop a polygon mask into the node field and connect this polygon mask with your media in node. Now go to your polygon mask and click once on the invert box. Now your task is to mask out your character, in my case it's 6-9. Now again click once on the invert box and now you have to increase the soft edge a little bit. 0.0063 should work for you. Now add another polygon node between your first polygon node and your media in node. Now go to your second polygon node, go to your paint mode and change that to subtract. And now try to cut 6.9½ by creating a rectangle shape with your polygon mask. And now click once on the invert box so that your lower part of your character is visible. Now left click on your media in one node and press shift and spacebar at the same time and search for transform. Now it's important that you select this transform and press add. Okay, now go to your third frame and go to transform and make sure that your center X and center Y values and your size is keyframed. And now go back to frame 0 and decrease the center Y value so that you no longer see this body. Now go to frame 4 and increase the size a little bit and change the center X and center Y value so that you see the full body. And now move on to frame 5 and here you change a little bit your center X and center Y values and so you get a little shakiness into your transition. Now go one frame forward to frame 6 and change your size to 1 and your center X and center Y values to 0.5. And now you have to duplicate these three nodes by highlighting them and press Ctrl C and Ctrl V. And now you have to connect this little dot to this little dot. And now go back to your second polygon mask and click once on the invert box. So now you should see all parts of your character. Now left click once your second media in node and press shift and spacebar at the same time and search for transform. Left click transform and press add. So now you go to frame 8 and click a keyframe on the center X and center Y values and click a keyframe on size. Now go to your merge node and go to your operator and change that from over to under. Now go back to your transform 2 node and go to frame 5. Now you have to decrease your center Y value so that you no longer see the upper part of your character's body. Now you can see that your second part of your character is always visible, which shouldn't be the case. But we only need the second part of this character at frame 6 because it appears there. So go back to frame 5 and here you go to your polygon 1 node of your second part and you decrease your level to 0 and you make a keyframe. Now go to frame 6 and increase the level bar to 1. Now again go to your transform 2 node and go to frame 9 and increase the size a little bit. Also change the position of your center X and center Y value a little bit. Then go to frame 11 and change the size to 1 and your center X and center Y values to 0.5. And it's also important that you look for a cut between your both body parts. So in frame 10 you see here's a line and we have to close this line by changing the center Y value. And now the animation looks like this. This animation is for sure fine, but I want to add some glow, so I go back into Fusion. And now go to your Merge 1 node and press Shift and Spacebar at the same time. Now search for Glow. And now it's really important that you select the second Glow option, because otherwise your video won't look good. So select this Glow option and press Add. So now first zoom out and go to frame 3. And here with the Glow node selected, increase your Shine threshold to 1 and create a keyframe. Now go to frame 4. And decrease the shine threshold to 0.5. Then go to frame 5 and create also a keyframe on your shine threshold. Now go to frame 8 and increase your shine threshold to 0.7. And now go to frame 9 and decrease your shine threshold to 0.4. And now you only have to increase the gain, the gamma and the saturation a little bit. So increase these three sliders to your liking. And yes, I have forgotten something, so go to frame 10. Also make sure to make a keyframe here and go to frame 12 and increase your shine threshold to 1. So I hope that this new transition could help you a little bit, and if so, then like and sub to my channel. Or if you want to, you can watch this video right here. So thanks for your attention and bye.